In the previous lecture, we have learned how to use gRPC interceptors to authenticate users. However, the API that we used to log in users was insecure, which means the username and password were being sent in plain text and can be read by anyone who listens to the communication between the client and server. So today we will learn how to secure the gRPC connection using TLS. If you haven't watched my video about SSL and TLS, I highly recommend you to watch it first, to have a deep understanding about TLS before continue. There are three types of gRPC connections. The first one is insecure connection, which we've been using since the beginning of this course. In this connection, all data transferred between client and server is not encrypted, so please don't use it for production. The second type is connection secure by server-side TLS. In this case, all the data is encrypted, but only the server needs to provide its TLS certificate to the client. You can use this type of connection if the server doesn't care which client is calling its API. The third and strongest type is connection secured by mutual TLS. We use it when the server also needs to verify who's calling its services. So in this case, both client and server must provide their TLS certificates to each other. In this video, we will learn to implement both server-side and mutual TLS in Golang. So let's start. First, we need the script to generate TLS certificate. So I'm going to copy it to our PC book project. I encourage you to watch my video about how to create and sign TLS certificate to understand how this script works. Basically, this script contains three parts. First, generate CA's private key and its sell side certificate. Second, create web server's private key and CSR. And third, use CA's private key to sign the web server's CSR and get back its certificate. The generated files that we care about in this video are the CA's certificate, the CA's private key, the server's certificate, and the server's private key. I'm going to add a new command to the make file to run the certificate generation script. It's very simple. We just cd to the cert folder, run gen.sh, then get out of that folder. And we should add this search command to the phony list. Now let's try it in the terminal. Run make cert. Excellent. All files are regenerated successfully. Next step, I will show you how to secure our gRPC connection with server-side TLS. Let's open server main.go file. I will add a function to load TLS credentials. It will return a transport credentials object or an error. For the server-side TLS, we need to load server certificate and private key. So we use tls.load x509 key pair function to load the server cert.pam and server key.pam files from the cert folder. If there's an error, just return it. Else, we create the transport credentials from them. We make a TLS config object with the server certificate. And we set the client auth field to no client cert, because we're just using server-side TLS. Finally, we call credentials.newTLS with that config and return it to the caller. Okay, the loadTLS credentials function is done. In the main function, we call that function to get the TLS credentials object. If an error occurs, we just write a fatal lock. Otherwise, we add the TLS credentials to the gRPC server by using the gRPC.crets option. And that's it for the server. Let's run it in the terminal. The server is started. Now if we run the client, it failed because we haven't enabled TLS on the client side yet. So let's do that. Similar to what we did on the server, I also add a function to load TLS credentials from files. But this time, we only need to load the certificate of the CA who signed the server certificate. The reason is, client needs to verify the authenticity of the certificate it gets from the server to make sure that it's the right server it wants to talk to. So here we load the cacert.pam file, then create a new x509 cert pool and append the cacert.pam to that pool. Finally, we create the credentials and return it. Note that we only need to set the root CIS field, which contains the trusted CIS certificate. Now, in the main function, there are two connections which are still insecure. We will need to replace them with a secure TLS. Let's call loadTLS credentials function to get the credentials object. Then change the gRPC.withInsecure call to gRPC.withTransportCredentials and pass in the TLS credentials object that we've created. Similar for this connection. And we're done. Let's try it out. This time the requests are successfully sent to the server. Perfect. There's one thing I want to show you here. Remember that when we develop on localhost, it's important to add the IP 0000 as a subject alternative name or SAN extension to the certificate. Let's see what will happen if we remove this from the config file. Then regenerate the certificate. Restart the server. And run the client again. As you can see, there's an error saying that the TLS handshake failed because it cannot validate the certificate for 0000 since the subject alternative names doesn't contain this IP address. On production, it will be okay because we use domain names instead. Alright, so now you know how to enable server-side TLS for your gRPC connection. Let's learn how to enable mutual TLS. At the moment, the server has already shared its certificate with the client. For mutual TLS, the client also has to share its certificate with the server. So let's update this script to create and sign a certificate for the client. Let's say for this tutorial, we use the same CA to sign both server and client certificate. In the real world, we might have multiple clients with different certificates signed by different CAs. Now let's run makecert to regenerate the certificate. Okay, the client certificate and private key are ready. To enable mutual TLS, on the server side, we should change this client auth field to require and verify client cert. And we also need to provide a list of certificates of the trusted CA who signs our client certificate. In our case, we only have one single CA that signs both server and client certificate. So we can simply copy the codes that we've written on the client side to load CA certificate and create a new certificate pool. Then just update the variable names and error messages a bit to reflect the fact that this should be the CA who signs client certificate. And we're done with the server. Let's run it in the terminal. Now if we connect the current client to this new server, it will fail because the server now also requires client to send its certificate. Let's go to the client code to fix this. I will just copy the code to load certificate on the server side and change these files to clientcert.pam and clientkey.pam. Then we have to add the client certificate to this TLS config by setting the certificate field, just like what we did on the server side. Okay, now if we rerun the client, all the requests will be successful. Awesome. One last thing before we finish. the client and server's private key that we used are not encrypted. It's because we use a notes option when generating them. If we remove this notes option and run makecert, we will be asked to provide a passphrase to encrypt the server's private key. And the generated private key of the server is encrypted, as you can see here. If we try to start the server with this key, it will return an error. Cannot load TLS credentials. That's because the key is encrypted. Of course, we can add more codes to decrypt the key with a passphrase. But I think in the end, we still have to protect the passphrase by keeping it somewhere safe, so we can always store our unencrypted private key in that place as well. For example, if you use Amazon Web Service, you can store your private key or any other secret in encrypted format with AWS Secret Manager. Or you can use HashiCorp's Vault for the same purpose. And that's everything I want to share with you in this video. I hope you find it useful. Thanks a lot for watching. See you guys in the next one.